Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. Namaste. Sat Sri Akal. Buenos dias. My name is Raja Saleem Akhtar. Welcome in this new video.
Exercises. Number one, if R is rational, R not equal to zero, and X is irrational, prove that R plus X and Rx are irrational. Solution. First, suppose R plus X is rational. We shall use contradiction method. Therefore, R plus X can be written as P beta Q, where PQ belongs to Z, Q is not equal to 0, and P comma Q equal to 1 in the lowest form. Only one common divisor. This can be written as X is equal to P over Q minus R. Since this R is rational, given in the question, therefore, we take R is equal to P1 over Q1, where P1 Q1 belongs to Z, Q1 is not equal to 0, and also P1 Q1 in the lowest form. Hence, X is equal to P over Q minus P1 over Q1. This implies X is equal to PQ1 minus QP1 over QQ1. Which is rational. But X is irrational. Hence, this is a contradiction. This implies R plus X is irrational. Sum of rational and irrational is irrational. You have proved it. Now, we shall use contradiction method. Similarly, to prove for Rx, suppose Rx is rational, therefore Rx can be written as P over Q, where P comma Q belongs to Z, Q is not equal to 0, and PQ are in the lowest form. Only one is the divisor. This can be written as X is equal to B over Q into 1 over R. Since R is rational, therefore R can be written as P1 over Q1, where P1, Q1 belongs to Z, Q1 is not equal to 0, and P1, Q1 equal to 1, that is in the lowest form. This can be written as, hence, X is equal to P over Q into 1 over R is P1 over Q1, this implies R is equal to P over Q into Q1 over P1, this implies X is equal to PQ over PQ1 over QP1. This implies X is rational, which is again contradiction. Because X is given irrational, hence R X is irrational, hence the solution product of rational and irrational is irrational. You have proved it. Question 2. Prove that there is no rational number whose square is 12. Very easy. Solution. Suppose 12 under root is rational, therefore 12 under root can be written as 12 under root is equal to P over Q, where P comma Q belongs to Z, Q is not equal to 0, and P and Q are in the lowest form. This can be written as 12 is equal to P square over Q square, or P square is equal to 12 Q square. Equation number 1. This implies Q square is equal to P square over 12. This can be written as Q square is equal to P square over 4 into 3 or 2 square into 3. This implies 2 square divides P square and 3 divides P square. This implies 2 divides P and 3 divides P. This implies 2 and 3 are prime divisors of P. This implies their product also divides P. This implies 6 divides P. So it can be written as P over 6 equal to A, where A is an integer. This implies P is equal to 6A. Now putting P is equal to 6A in equation 1, we get P square 6A square. This will be 36A square equal to 12Q square. This implies 3A square equal to Q square. This implies A square is equal to Q square over 3. This implies 3 divides Q square. This implies 3 will also divide Q. But 3 also divides P. Question 3. Prove the preposition the axioms for multiplication imply the following statements. A, if x not equal to 0 and xy equal to xz, then y is equal to z. B, if x not equal to 0 and xy is equal to x, then y is equal to 1. C, if x not equal to 0 and xy is equal to 1, then y is equal to 1 over x. D, if x not equal to 0, then 1 over x equal to x. Solution. Question 4. Let E be a non-empty subset. Of an ordered set suppose alpha is a lower bound of E and beta is an upper bound of E. Prove that alpha less than equal to beta. Solution, very easy. Only keep in mind the definitions of lower bound and upper bound. Since alpha is a lower bound of E, therefore by definition of lower bound we have alpha less than equal to x for every x belongs to E. Inequality 1. Since beta is an upper bound of E, therefore by definition of an upper bound we have x less than equal to beta for every x belongs to E. Inequality 2. Note these 1 and 2. Now from 1 and 2 we have alpha less than equal to x less than equal to beta for every x belongs to E. This implies alpha less than equal to beta. Equality case also exists. Hence the proof. Question 5. Let A be a non-empty set of real numbers which is bounded below let minus A be the set of all real numbers minus x where x belongs to A. Prove that infimum of A equal to minus supremum of minus A. Solution, let infimum of A equal to beta we need to show that minus beta is equal to supremum of minus a, or beta is equal to minus supremum of minus a. First, we show that minus beta is an upper bound for minus a. By definition of infimum, infimum A is equal to beta implies that beta less than equal to x for every x belongs to A. This implies minus beta greater than minus x for every x belongs to A. This implies minus beta greater than minus x for every minus x belongs to minus a. Or minus x less than equal to minus beta for every minus x belongs to minus a. This shows that minus beta is an upper bound for minus a. Secondly, we show that minus beta is the supremum or least upper bound for minus a. For this, we will show that for every r belongs to r such that r less than minus beta, there exists minus x belongs to minus a such that r less than minus x. For this, let R be an arbitrary real number such that R less than minus beta. This implies minus R greater than R beta less than minus r, since beta is equal to infimum of A, there exists x belongs to A such that x less than minus r, therefore this implies there exists x belongs to A such that r less than minus 6